When you're downloading textures online, or 3D models with textures with them, you can sometimes get textures which are named differently, but they're used for more or less the same parameter. Today, we're going to be talking about the difference between a roughness map and a gloss map, which is really important for knowing how to use maps correctly inside a Blender. If you want to follow along with this tutorial, make sure to download the textures in the description below so you can follow along. I'll press Shift A, and then under Mesh, I'm just going to choose Plane, as this will give me a nice square UV for using a square based texture. I'm then going to change my timeline here by left clicking the clock and then choosing shader editor. Then I'm going to change my line style here to object, and this will allow me to add a material to our selected object. So I'll left click my plane to select it, and then I'm just going to go ahead and press plus new, and I'm then going to zoom in. You'll see right here we have a parameter called roughness, and this gloss and roughness map that I'm talking about today is going to be affecting this parameter here. I'm going to go into material preview just so we can see all the changes we're making to our material. But now I've done that, you'll notice our material is black even though the base color here is white. To fix this is very simple. I'm just going to come up to render properties here, and I'm going to change my render engine to Eevee. Then I'm going to enable ray tracing, left click the drop down. If you're using Blender 4.2, there'll be a setting here called max roughness. Simply set that to 1 to fix the issue. For us using Blender 4.3, come to fast GI approximation and change the number to 1 on threshold. If you're still having issues, it may be that your computer is incompatible with Blender versions 4.3 and 4.2. In which case, I would recommend using Blender 4.1, which is still a pretty good version of Blender. Then I'm just going to come up to Render Engine and change it back to Cycles. Now let's go ahead and add our image. So I'm going to press Shift A, and then under Texture, I'm going to choose Image Texture. Image Texture allows us to add a texture from our computer into our Blender file. Now once your textures are downloaded, we're going to go into the File Explorer. Here I'm going to come to my Brick Example Textures.zip, and then all I need to do is left click Extract All up here, or you can right click and press Extract All. Then you can choose a location on your computer to save these textures, but I'm just going to keep them in the Downloads folder for simplicity's sake. Then you can go ahead and press Extract, but you can see I've already got a folder here with the textures, so I'm just going to press Cancel. Back in Blender, I'm then going to go ahead and press Open on the image texture. Then inside of my Downloads folder, I'm going to come to my Brick Example Textures folder, double click it to open it, and here you'll be greeted with all the different textures. You can see all of these are simple square-based textures for you to use inside a Blender. The ones we're focusing on today are the gloss and the roughness one. You'll notice that these ones are both black and white, but they're also the complete invert of each other. Notice how the areas which are darker here on the roughness are the areas which are brighter on the gloss. This is the most fundamental thing to understand about gloss maps and roughness maps, is that they're both used for the roughness parameter in Blender, but one of them is inverted. Since Blender uses the roughness parameter, that means that the roughness texture here is the one which will work in Blender by default, but gloss is another way of representing this information in 3D, but it is an inverted form of this roughness. I'm going to left click the roughness one and press open image. Then I'm going to press Shift A, and then under input, I'm going to choose texture coordinate, and then I'm going to plug UV into vector. This will just make sure that we're using our UVs in order to place this texture on our object. Since this is a black and white image, we're going to change our color space from sRGB, which means all color ranges, to non-color. And then all we need to do is plug our color into the roughness. Now if I zoom in here, you can see how we have some reflections for our brick. If I left click my image texture here and press Shift D to duplicate, and then press this folder button to open image, this time in my folder, I'm going to left click gloss and press open image. Now I'm going to plug the UV into the vector of this one, set this one's color space to non-color as well, so the same setup so far, and then I'm going to plug my color into the roughness. You will notice how the reflections have now changed, and the areas which were once shiny have now become more rough. So, as I mentioned earlier, roughness is actually the correct one to use. But sometimes you will get a set of textures where you will only have the option for gloss and you won't have an option for roughness. In which case, what we'll need to do is we'll need to invert the gloss to effectively turn it back into a roughness texture. To do that, it's really simple. I'll press Shift A, and then I'm going to come to the search bar, and I'm just going to search for invert. Then I can left click this invert color, plug the color of my gloss into the color here, and then this color socket into our roughness. You will now notice that we have the exact same result, even though we're using the gloss texture. And that's because we've inverted it. So the main takeaway from this lesson is that whenever you get a gloss texture, make sure to invert it if you're using it in Blender. Do keep in mind that different 3D softwares might use gloss by default instead of roughness. So it's important to check that first when applying textures for other 3D software. But in Blender, roughness is the default. So whenever you have a gloss texture, you're going to want to invert it first before plugging it into the roughness socket, which will then allow us to control the clarity of our reflections effectively using a texture, which is the job of this roughness parameter. If you want to understand more about these parameters here on the Principal BSDF shader, I highly recommend checking out my Principal BSDF in-depth video here. Apart from that, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.